Hello, everybody, and happy holidays, November-ish. Yeah, not quite Christmas time yet, but it is Christmas holiday time at Disneyland, and that's where I am, as always. Standing over here by the wishing well, because it's a little quieter over here. It's a Sunday, and they had the Avengers Marathon stuff going on this weekend, so I wasn't sure what that would do to the crowds, but the line into the parking lot, into the parking structure, was backed up to the highway, so that usually gives an indication it's going to be pretty busy. So far, it doesn't look that way in the parks quite yet with the crowds, but I have a feeling it will. Haven't really done much yet. It's about 10 o'clock. Park's been open for about an hour. Basically, I've spent the majority of my time so far this morning standing in line waiting for this, the Fast Pass to meet the Frozen for the Frozen Royal reception. So it is a good idea that they did that, but I'll check in later. Is there any doubt I'd ride the Little Mermaid ride again? Of course not. And you got Christmas music in the background too, so Christmas music and Little Mermaid? Shoot. Alright, so just got off of Soarin'. Again, no surprise that I make sure to hit that one. Probably actually going to be doing that one several times over the next couple of days, because I know I'm not coming back until January for sure. Or I know that's my next time, maybe, but I don't know if I'll be out earlier, but they're closing it in January for several months to refurb, so kind of got to take in as many more rides on it as I can. Also a bit disappointing, one of my other favorite attractions, the Muppet Vision, is closed today. So I'm hoping that opens again tomorrow, just because I always have a lot of fun doing that one, because I think it's underrated. But also, kind of trying to think of what I'm going to do in this video. I kind of go on the fly a lot of times, but since it's Christmas, I thought maybe I'd kind of point out some of the Christmas-specific stuff here. So we'll see. Specific areas is the Jingle Jangle Jamboree at the Big Thunder Mountain Ranch. So lots of different activities and crafts and stuff for the kids, and then characters in their Christmas outfits and Santa Claus and such. So maybe just a look at that. So somewhere over there is Mrs. Claus, and Santa Goofy is somewhere over there too. But it's cool. It's a little kids area mainly, but cool stuff.
Hello.
How are you two?
Good.
I'm very excited to meet the both of you.
Pretty cool.
Wow.
Very merry.
She's
birthday.
Pretty cool too.
Yeah, I'm not quite frozen yet.
Oh,
I'm
you're not as
cool.
Frozen
I'm getting
as
there.
Okay. I see.
But
oh my goodness.
I live in Arizona though, so it's very hard to get frozen.
So. Oh, it doesn't snow there.
No, it's very hot.
Oh, it's very
over 100 degrees.
So. Mm-hmm.
We should probably. Well, Olaf would love it there, I'm sure.
Yeah, yeah. If he thinks he loves summer, he should come to Arizona. That'll tell him if he loves summer or not.
We'll have to take
there you go.
How are you two doing today?
Oh, very well.
Good.
How are you?
Very good, thank you.
That's great. I had lots of chocolate this morning for breakfast. And I
That's
milk
good.
And chocolate chip pancakes. It was great.
Sounds good.
It was a great start to the day.
A lot of chocolate, yeah, for sure.
Would you like a photo with us?
Absolutely. Okay, so it's been a little while since I filmed, so much so that I'm not even sure what I've done since the last time. But I did do both shows of the Royal Theater and Fantasy Fair, the Tangled and the Beauty and the Beast. I got some pictures and autographs from the Fair Maidens, which was one of the goals of mine for this trip. Went through the line, which I had mentioned before this morning. I got in the Fast Pass for the Frozen meet and greet, so I met Anna and Elsa and got their autographs and took a selfie with Elsa, which was fun. It's definitely worth it just to deal with, you know, you're dealing with a line, but it's not as bad now that they've done the Fast Pass process, which I think is a great idea. So I'll probably film some more Christmas stuff as it gets darker. See ya.
Yeah.
can't really see my face because it's dark, but just to kind of show some of the things they do at Christmas, obviously they have the tree down at Main Street and everything lit up, kind of walking the Main Street route with different garland and lights and such. Then obviously the big and then all these other trees have lights on them. And the big attraction is obviously Sleeping Beauty Castle, which, in my opinion, this is my absolute favorite time of year for the castle when they decorate it. Now, right now it's just kind of generic, and then once they do the fireworks and they have the special lighting ceremonies, they'll have it lit up bright white. And it also tends to light up everything down Main Street with bright white lights as well, and that looks really awesome, so I hope to get some footage of that. In the meantime, I will look for some other Christmas-specific things to show y'all. Encompasses the entire structure, but I missed part of it because I started walking away and then I had to come back, but cool stuff. And I was trying to say earlier that Small World was another thing that light up for the holidays. My camera battery died in the middle of my speech, so that's why you didn't see that. See ya. So similarly over here in California Adventure now, you know, obviously they have the basic decorations. They have the tree here in Buena Vista Street. And you'll just notice all the other decor. I'm thinking what they're doing to keep with the theming of it being like in the 20s is maybe this was the Christmas decorations, the types they had in the 20s? I don't know, I'd have to look that up, but it wouldn't surprise me really. Sorry, I forgot to mention, over here also at the Elias and Company, I don't think he's there now, but during the day, Santa Claus is there where you can sit on his lap, give him your list, all that good stuff. So, visit Santa Claus. Got canceled because of the wind, and they did the little light up the Christmas tree with snow thing, but otherwise that's pretty much it, and I'm pretty much beat, so I will be back again tomorrow, and I'll try and cover anything I might have missed as far as Christmas related stuff. Excuse me. Any of the big shows I'm pretty much not covering, the fireworks, World of Color, parades. I might have a little bits and pieces of it somewhere, but mainly if you want to see more clips of that, you can check out my Christmas video from last year. I have a little bit more footage of each of those on there, but they're all pretty long, so I didn't want to just film the whole thing. And lots of copyrighted music on there. Alright. I think that'll do it for this evening. So, hope you enjoyed this portion. I'll be back for at least something tomorrow. More Christmas stuff, more character meet and greets. We'll see what happens. So, I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.
Hi there.
Hello there, how are you?
I'm wonderful, how are you today?
Good, thank you.
Oh, good. I like your buttons.
Thank you very
much. Did you make those yourself?
No, but I have a friend who made them for me.
Oh, wow. Is it... Oh, it's your un-birthday.
It's un-birthday, mm-hmm. Yeah. So, how are you today?
I'm wonderful. Thank you for asking.
Wonderful. Do you like the park at this time of year when it's the holidays?
I do. When it's Christmas time, yeah. It's so much fun. We get to hear special music all the time, and Mickey and all of his friends get to wear cute little outfits.
Yeah. Now, do you and Eric do anything special
for the holidays? Well, we do like to make lots of food, and we go on lots of boat rides since he has his own ship. We like to take Max out, and we like to go visit Flounder and say hello to all of my family under the sea.
Very nice.
Do you have anything special you do for the holidays?
Nothing in particular. I just like to spend time with my family.
So. You do? That's fun.
Yeah.
Me too.
Yeah. Well, I'd love to get a photo with you.
Oh, of course. That would be wonderful.
It's Faun, if I'm correct,
Faun,
right?
That's right. You must be a fairy expert.
Oh, not quite.
No, not
I'm
quite.
I'm getting
still
there.
Still learning. Okay, you know, we all have special talents. That's like the basic fairy knowledge.
Right.
I'm an animal talent.
Okay.
You're really the best ones. Don't tell Tinkerbell I said so. Being an animal talent would be really cool. What do you think your special talent would be?
Oh, gosh.
It's a trick question.
Yeah, there's so many different ones to choose from. It would be hard to tell.
You could be multi-talented.
That's true.
Cool.
Do you have a favorite animal?
Okay, that's a trick question. It's hard to pick a favorite when you like all of them. You know, they're all my friends.
Yeah.
I think, you know, it kind of changes with the season. You know, they kind of change with the season. Oh, thank you. I have to say, while it's still warm and everyone's kind of playful, these squirrels. We like playing hide and seek together. That's my favorite game. They always find the best hiding spots.
Yeah.
Should we get a picture together?
Absolutely. Hello there.
For me, thank
you. Yes.
How's it
flying? Very good. How are you today?
I'm Pixie Bird. Is it your unbirthday?
Yes, it is.
I've heard about those things.
Yeah.
There's a crazy man in a hat that always comes and yells to me about this teapot.
Yeah.
And he's always talking about unbirthdays, and he says fairies don't have unbirthdays. But the way he explained them to me, I would think fairies do have unbirthdays because we never celebrate birthdays.
Yeah, I would think so then.
See, so...
That makes sense.
But, I mean, nothing he really makes any sense.
Yeah.
This isn't his teapot that I know. His name isn't in it. My name's all over it now.
Yeah.
There you go.
Thank you.
Close that up.
You look very nice in your winter coat.
Thanks. Yeah, I thought it'd be good. Although, your desk did a lovely job on the sun, so maybe I didn't need it, huh?
It is a little warm
today.
I've
been trying to come prepared more often now. A little bit of extra pixie dust, maybe long leaves, and always come prepared. I have my teapot all set up as a pirate trap.
Very good.
I know, I've learned lessons.
Yeah.
I just keep breaking rules, it's the thing. But I always figure my way out.
Well, that's good.
Did you want any pictures?
Absolutely. Yep. Hey, everybody. So, I just realized I've kind of been here like half the day today, second day, and I don't think I've really done any vlogging. I've got some clips and video stuff from meeting some characters and such. And I went to the Magical Map show, but I haven't really talked much. So, it's really the only thing I have. I don't know. My brain's all foggy today, but... It's actually really busy today. It seems actually busier than it was yesterday, which is kind of surprising, but still a good day though. When you're an annual pass holder, you come enough, you don't have to worry about trying to hit every ride if you stay here, otherwise days like this would be hard, but you just kind of do what you like. But shout out to Rapunzel and the Magical Map Show, really good, and see you soon. So I am currently sitting outside the pool area of the Grand Californian, and you can see the hotel here. I went inside a little disappointed, actually. They didn't have all the Christmas decorations in the lobby yet. Usually they have the giant tree in the middle, but they didn't have that this time. But If you want to see that, again, that's in my video from last year. So you can click on either the parks playlist, or I keep referencing my Christmas video from last year. I may just put that one on by itself. So I also just came from seeing the Beauty and the Beast show at the Royal Theater again. And I met Belle afterwards and met some more of the Faire maidens that I didn't meet yesterday. So they're all so cool. I really recommend for folks who haven't seen it and gone to go to that and stay afterwards for the first couple of showings of each show, because you get a chance possibly to meet the stars and you meet the Faire maidens. And the maidens really are just so cool. Like, literally, and I'm thinking it's Christmas time, like the Grinch or even Scrooge McDuck would smile watching these ladies at the show. It's hard to focus on the story, really. And they're so nice in person. And, you know, they'll sign autographs, take pictures, and everything else. So definitely go see that. I'm trying to think if I'm missing anything else so far. California Adventure does have the Viva Navidad thing, which I think when I check the times, I've missed all the little parade things, but that's another one that, again, is on my Christmas video from last year. So you really need to see that to catch some more of these things. Don't click away from this one, just see that and still watch this video, those two, and use all the views I can get. Okay, see you later. And with that, my night is over. I'm ready to head home. I went and saw the last performance of Magical Map to catch the lovely and talented Rapunzel again. Almost had a chance to meet her after the show too, but things just didn't work correctly. My fault, really. So hopefully one of the next times I'm here, I might get that shot. But pretty good 2 days. Busy, but caught a lot of good shows, and looking forward again to coming back. So definitely back in January for sure, and might have a co-host on my next trip here. So we'll see. As always, click the link to subscribe, like, share, whatever you want to do. Click the link to my other playlists. And yeah, that's it. So until next time, see you later, everybody.